Hi, it's nice to see you guys, and yeah, welcome to IDDD program in computational engineering. To start with, let me introduce myself. I'm Prasad Patnaik from the Department of Applied Mechanics. As you guys know, you know, computing is pervasive, and the way in which the computer science and IT fields have evolved is a kind of phenomenal explosion of progress. The same is true in the context of science and engineering. And the progress in science and engineering is closely tied to the, you know, the science of computing as well. In fact, some of the engineering analysis and designs that we are seeing in a wide range of disciplines such as aerospace, civil engineering, mechanical, material science and engineering, ocean engineering, they're all facilitated essentially because of extremely good computing facilities, which have become pervasive. And it's very important that we understand in a singular way the discipline specific engineering aspects of our fields. And as you know, there are three broad routes to doing engineering designs. One is to conduct experiments and come up with correlations. Other is to kind of come up with analytical closed form solutions for simplified model scenarios and sort of perform engineering analysis and design. And the other third paradigm is essentially doing modeling and simulation to be able to perform a broad range of modeling and simulation, which is going to hinge heavily on the on essentially translating your engineering problem into a wide scope that consists of, in a very technical sense, AX equal to B kind of a matrix. The A matrix could be a billion by billion matrix, and the vector of unknowns, the X vector, is the vector of unknowns that you are trying to sort of figure out. And it could be coming from a civil engineering based truss analysis or a bridge structure. It could be the machine components that you have analyzed using a CAD geometry, or it could be coming from an ocean engineering sloshing dynamics kind of example. In that spirit, looking at the large scale matrix solutions is critical, whether you call it directly as AX equal to B or a system of simultaneous equations to be solved, that certainly needs quite a bit of computing skill set and understanding of data structures, algorithms, and then high performance computing per se. That's the kind of background that comes from computer science. And without domain specific understanding of your either civil, mechanical, or material science or ocean engineering kind of problem, you will not be able to sort of move forward or appreciate the nature of, so essentially the computational engineering is going to build upon whatever is your existing discipline. More of computational engineering is going to be something along the following lines. Of course, this, this is surely, for students with aerospace, biotechnology, chemical engineering, mechanical, material science, naval arc kind of backgrounds. And high performance computing is certainly critical because you have a system of equations which are running into a matrix of size million by million or billion by billion. And surely what is needed perhaps is the background and focus on computational engineering coming from discipline specific aspects. It could be computational fluid dynamics if you are interested in looking at the fluid forces and moments coming due to the fluid thermal problem, or it could be stress analysis and structural dynamics kind of background, or it could be computational material science. These are very representative broad disciplines or sub-disciplines that we can think of within computational engineering. And who should be choosing this program is very important. It's surely going to be discipline specific, and those who are interested in coding are the guys who are certainly most welcome to this program, and those who are algorithmically inclined, and in fact there are boys who will do thorough analysis and prove before even coding it that through analysis it will perhaps take a certain amount of computational time. well in advance. In fact, we are interested in students who are actually going to solve engineering problems in the traditional fields, who are able to sort of compete with the existing software giants and then, you know, perform codes from the scratch, and therefore they may be perhaps the right kind of material for startups and things like that. And surely we need the smart guys. Therefore, we assume that a good CGPA is a kind of prerequisite. But there are also scenarios where not so, good CGPAs are also available in a number of other situations. Who are interested in computational engineering. And this is an IDDD. You can start either in sixth or seventh semester, there is no doubt. And strong numerical methods, liking is very critical, and a little bit of math strength is very useful. Of course, one can think of a possible substream. It's not very mandatory. One can have a mix of courses if somebody is doing fluid structure interaction, let us say. They can also pick up quite a number of courses from the CFD substream and also the computational solid mechanics kind of substream. It's also possible if somebody is doing a material science of biomaterials, one can pick up courses from computational biology as well as computational material science. These are only suggested substreams. It's not that one has to stick to it. And the basic core courses come from these four traditional strands that I mentioned, computational implementation, where your algorithmic background as well as the data structures background needs to be strengthened, and numerical methods is certainly very critical. You have a plethora of choices. Discretization methods, we expect at least a finite element, finite volume kind of a background in one of these courses. And high performance computing, of course, is the core. These are the four core courses, which will again have plenty of options to choose from, and suggested specializations at this point of time are computational fluid dynamics and computational solid mechanics, so that your own energy is not completely diffused in, doing a lot of grazing of courses here and there. And we are suggesting a certain strand of courses so that your own background looks very solid in a certain direction rather than looking very diffuse not showing a clear focus. To start with, let me show you the core structure of the computational engineering. Core 1 is from the Core 1 basket. There are at least three courses available. Core 2, of course, I'm going to show you in a short time, and then preferably chosen from the same elective stream. Elective 1 typically is taken from computational fluid dynamics or computational biology or computational material science or computational, Again, this is not, there is no hard and fast rule that you have to pick up only from a particular elective stream. There could be newer elective streams which are likely to pop up as well. Core 3, Core 4 is in the eighth semester. But it's also possible that you can start early. There are students who have started early as fifth semester because of certain slot availabilities. And that sort of a thing is possible. And there are also labs related to computational laboratory as well as high performance computing lab, where your own skill set in MPI and CUDA coding is facilitated. So let me show you what are these four core baskets. As I mentioned, core 1 is on the numerical methods. Core 2 will be on the computational implementation. Core 3 will be on the discretization methods, and core 4 is on high performance computing. And of course, in the ninth semester, you will be having a summer project or a summer industrial internship. You don't have to sacrifice your traditional summer internship that you are excited about. And also the project 2 component technically starts in the in the month of August, soon after your the summer vacation ends. And elective 3 is preferably, again, there is one elective 3 in the ninth semester, and one can finish it early also. There is no hard and fast rule that one has to do only elective 3 in the ninth semester. And project 2 component typically is can be combined with project 3. Project 2 and 3 are kind of, ninth and tenth semester load, which is typically done as a single, big project. And the total number of credits, of course, is 158. And project 1, 2, 3 grades are assigned at the end of each semester, so that your own placements would look, with an enhanced CGPA, which is perhaps very attractive when you go to the placement in the month of December, those, devil hour interviews with the analytics companies, perhaps. So the early bird starts is possible with core 1 and core 2 and, some of the courses in the 6th semester onwards. You are most welcome to get started early. So the core 1, there are numerical methods. There are a wide range of numerical methods based on the flavor and liking of your interest, and one can pick up any one of these courses. Regarding computational implementation, one can think of choosing any of these courses, like MA5910 if you are more mathematically inclined, or ID6105. In fact, Professor Rupesh has taught this ID6105 in the last semester. He is from computer science, and he and Professor Madhu Muthiam have been extremely, supportive of this particular course. And IE4371 is another option that one can choose from. These are all possible computational implementation related courses. And there is a HPC course. Again, you have an option even in HPC. The hope is that there will be more courses populated in these core baskets, so that core 3 and core 4 also have a certain number of baskets available. And one can look into the details. And again, the core 3 basket is coming from the discretization methods. We suggest a finite element, finite volume, or a traditional spectral elements kind of a course can be done under discretization methods. Under computational fluid dynamics, again, one can choose 3 different electives, such as foundations of CFD, or along with that, one can also choose a turbulence and a turbulence modeling kind of a course you want to specialize in fluid dynamics. Or if you want to specialize in computational material science, you can choose 3 distinct courses from either computational material science or computational solid mechanics. These are only representative, and there is no hard and fast rule that you must stick to a particular stream. In fact, it's the program is highly flexible. Maybe, I just thought there are instances where students have undergone these kind of courses, which are completely not related to any of those 3 or 4 streams that I mentioned in the previous slides. And there are instances they said, okay, I want to specialize in computational vision. And it surely, consists of computational geometry kind of, core course. But the onus of having the prerequisites is completely on you. It's not that we are going to argue for your case where you do not have the prerequisites for a particular course. Therefore, these particular courses are not specifically mentioned under any of the streams. Okay. Thank you. And before I go, I just wanted to play this small video from one of our former students.
Hi, my name is Maitreyi Ramesh, and I graduated from IIT Madras in 2020 with an interdisciplinary dual degree. My bachelor's, B.Tech, was in metallurgical and materials engineering, and I got an M.Tech in computational engineering. So I'm pursuing a PhD at Northwestern University, and my research interest is computational material science. The field computational material science is quite interdisciplinary, and it sits at the intersection of material science, computational engineering, and mathematics. So I got introduced to this field in my second year of undergraduate, and because of the flexible nature of the curriculum at IIT Madras, which coincidentally was introduced in the year I joined it in 2015, I was able to explore this field in some detail by taking up electives of my choice. To my delight, when I was in my third year, the new interdisciplinary dual degree programs were announced with specializations like data science, computational engineering, robotics, etc. I was very thrilled to see computational engineering, and I ultimately converted from a 4-year bachelor's program to a 5-year interdisciplinary dual degree program in computational engineering. And in the process, I got to take up courses from different departments to strengthen the background in my field. So that included courses from departments like mathematics, mechanical engineering, applied mechanics, and so on top of my background in material science. And also my final year project had a very strong computational component. The extra year also gave me some more time to figure out my exact interests. And when I applied for PhD programs, I was very thrilled to get admits from very coveted programs around the world, including the likes of MIT and Caltech. Ultimately, it gave me the opportunity to truly find the convergence of my interests for a program that I liked. And that is why I'm now doing a PhD in material science and engineering at Northwestern in the first ever material science department in the world. And also I have a very, very strong research group of my choice. And looking back, I feel that I was able to utilize the flexibility of the program, which was first of all structured enough to give us some direction, and at the same time also had flexibility and loose definition of terms so that we could truly explore and tailor it to our interests. And I'm very grateful for that opportunity. And now I hope that I can gain enough exposure and hopefully return to India one day to continue my academic journey. Thank you.